Just touch yourself, say, Lord, gently rest upon me tonight, like the dew in the morning. And if you really mean it, come on and just lift your hands and say, thank you, Jesus.
Let's prophesy to one more person. Look at them. Come on, sing it. Like the dew in the morning.
don't know their testimony, so you don't know why they praise God the way they do. So tonight, if we get a little loose, don't worry about us. It's what the Lord has done for us that's allowing us to give him the glory and the honor and the praise that he deserves. I gotta say this again, because when I think of the goodness of Jesus, yeah, and everything he's done for me, there's a praise that springs up in my spirit. And many times when I try to control, I can't control it, because God has been good to me. Hallelujah! Glory to God. Bless the name of the Lord Jesus. Well, there's a little story in the Bible about the children of Israel and how they crossed over the Red Sea. And the Bible tells us that after they came over to the other side, that Miriam the prophetess gathered some of the women of Israel together. And they grabbed their tambourines and they began to sing, "I will sing unto the Lord, for he hath triumphed gloriously. The horse and the rider he's thrown into the sea." And I wrote this little song because many times it's good for us to rehearse the victories that the Lord has won for us. Amen. Many times the enemy can keep us bound because we don't remember where God has brought us from. This song is entitled "The Song of Mary."
I will sing unto the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. I will sing unto the Lord Most High, the horse on the rider he's thrown into the sea. I will sing unto the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. Oh, I will sing unto the Lord Most High, the horse on the rider he's thrown into the sea. I will sing, I will sing, I will sing unto the Lord Most High. I will sing, I will sing, the horse on the rider he's thrown into the sea. I will sing, I will sing, I will sing unto the Lord Most High. I will sing, I will sing, the horse on the rider he's thrown into the sea. I will sing unto the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. I will sing unto the Lord Most High, the horse on the rider he's thrown into the sea. And I will sing, I will sing, I will sing unto the Lord Most High. I will sing, I will sing, the horse on the rider he's thrown into the sea. And I will sing, I will sing, I will sing unto the Lord Most High. I will sing, I will sing, the horse on the rider he's thrown into the sea. Well, the Bible tells us that the prophetess Miriam gathered some of the women of Israel together, and they grabbed tambourines and they began to sing unto the Lord for what he had done for them. And this tonight is a little of what they've done.
My pastor and his wife, Bishop and Mrs. Charles E. Blake, for their example of excellence over the years and for allowing us to be able to come and to do this here at West Angeles Church. I appreciate you. I love you. And you know I support you. I got your back, Bishop. Amen. Come on, let's praise the Lord for our pastor, Bishop Charles E. Blake, and his wife, Sister Blake. Come on, y'all. You can do better than that. Amen. Special thanks I want to also acknowledge someone without whom I would not be alive, my mother, Mrs. Clarice Christie. Would you please stand? Amen. Let's praise the Lord for her on tonight. Oh, y'all, come on. That's my mama. Yeah, yeah. That's my mama.
Yeah. I believe that you can see the difference in praise and worship in individuals. Give a typical Sunday morning situation. Worshippers come to worship God. They come for not what they can get, but what they can give. Praisers come just to get a feeling, a good feel. You know, the difference between praise and worship, praise is the vehicle that gets us to the destination of worship. And so many times we find people so preoccupied with the vehicle that they fail to get to the destination of worship. And in St. John chapter 4, Jesus said that God is a spirit, and they that worship, not praise, those that worship him must worship in spirit and in truth. So we need to use the vehicle of praise. Don't let go of that vehicle, but reach the destination of worship. And when we reach the destination, get out of the vehicle and do business with God.
The Lord is saying that he desires that many of us would enter in. But we allow this world and the cares of this world to hinder us from entering into his presence. His desire is that we come before him. God is not a hard taskmaster. He's not in heaven with a big stick waiting to bop you over the head if you do something wrong. God is love. And his love for us should propel us to enter in, to let go of those things, to let go of those attitudes, those dispositions that would hinder us from entering into his presence. And yes, the Lord tonight is bidding us to come. He's saying, come on. Come on. Because in my presence, there is fullness of joy. There's everything that you need. There's everything that you could ever desire in my presence. The only thing that can't come in my presence is flesh. So we've got to crucify the flesh. You see, he's not going to do it for us. We've got to do it. And as we draw closer and closer to the coming of the Lord Zion, it's going to be so important that we lay aside every weight and every sin that easily besets us. And that we run with patience this race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. Come on, if you want to go into his presence, just lift those hands. Lift those hands. Bid me to come.
In the beginning, there was some resistance to what we now call praise and worship because, you know, there were groups of people that felt that we were going a different way or abandoning, you know, our roots, our heritage. And what we've come to find out, of course, is that, you know, God is a God of evolution, and ministry, in order to be effective, must also change. And the new move of praise and worship that we're seeing in the church now, I think, is just the next chapter in what God is trying to do in the church. And I think that Judy has a part in that.
Yes, Lord, I want to see you and I want to know you like I've never known you before. And I want to worship your name. And I do want to bless you. Because I love you, God. Worship and adore your holy name. Aya kasto to mashte. Umi alelesto ko sheba. God, we worship you. Magnify you tonight. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I want to see. I want to know you like I've never known you before. To walk with you and talk with you. Come on, if you know it, sing it. I want to see you. Yeah. I want to know you like I've never known you before. To walk with you and to talk with you, to know you all the more.
Come on, all over the room, lift those hands and sing it. I want to see you.
I want to see you.
Oh, if you mean it, come on, sing it. I want to know you.
I want to know you.
Like I've
like
never,
I've never known
you before.
Before.
To walk.
To walk with you.
And to talk.
To talk with you.
To know you all the
to
more.
To know you all.
Oh Lord, I love you, and I adore you. To you I open the door. To sup with you, and you with me, my one.
Physical experience. I don't just want doodads up and down my skin. I don't want to just feel good when I come to the house of the Lord, but I want to walk
with you and have conversation with you and know you all the more. To get up in the morning and do what I have to do, but then hear your voice. Go to work and then walk in your presence. That's what I wanna do. Talk and I wanna walk with you, Jesus. Yes, I do. I wanna be in your presence all day long, Lord, to walk with you.
Sanctified of God, the holy royal priesthood, if we would praise his name.
unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. Oh, give thanks unto the God of God. Great wonders to him that by wisdom made the heavens, to him that stretched out the earth above the waters.
My favorite song on this project was titled This Is The Day, and the reason being because God has showed me so many times we take the days for granted, but we have to live for the day. So this is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Don't focus on yesterday, don't focus on tomorrow, but focus on this day.
the Lord. There's a place in you where many have not gone. An intimacy that comes from time alone. Beyond this natural mind, leaving this earthly realm behind, we can go. In the outer courts, carnal minds can live, but I need something more than the inner courts can give. An experience with you, one so real and true, that's only found behind the veil. It's only found behind the veil.
Lead me to come. Lead me to come. I'll crucify my flesh so I can come.
Behind the veil, to commune with you, behind the veil.
I've attempted to do even with this project is to be as simple as possible, as simple as possible, so that the ordinary layperson can catch these songs, that they can sing them during their devotions, they can, you know, minister to the Lord anytime, any place, simply.
Help in the hills. And when David wrote this song, it is a song or a psalm of ascent. And we know in those days that the temple, Mount Zion, was on a mountain. And the people of the Lord, as they began to ascend the hill, began to think of the promise, began to think of what they would receive when they got to the house of God. So they weren't saying that there's help in the hills. They were thinking about what was on top of that hill. Mount Zion, where they could receive what they needed in the presence of God. Aren't you glad that we don't have to come to church to access the presence of God? And as we sing this song one more time, I want you to be grateful tonight that we no longer have to bring bullocks and lambs and doves. But all we have to do is offer him the sacrifice of praise, which is the fruit of our lips, giving thanks unto God, lifting up holy hands without wrath or doubting. And if you're excited about that tonight, come on, lift up your hands. Say, Lord, you're good, and I worship you, and I adore you. My help comes from you, who made heaven and earth. Come on, put those hands together. Let's praise him.
Somebody
And on the count of three, I want you to give God the best Shabbat that you can give him. With your hands uplifted. Hallelujah. And I want you to see, even as it were, the walls of Jericho that are in your life coming down. The Lord says to you tonight, shout, for he has given you the victory. And on the count of three, I want you to open your mouth the widest that you can get it. Give God the biggest Shabbat that you can give him, because you already have the victory. Don't stop worshiping. Come on. That's it. Hallelujah.
honor him, worship him, bless his name. We honor your name. We honor your name. We honor your name. We lift up our hands, Lord, and honor your name.
Come on, all over the room, lift those hands.
We honor your name. We honor your name.
We lift up our hands.
We lift up our hands, Lord,
and honor your name.
We honor your name.
Come on.
We honor your name.
We lift up our hands.
We lift up our hands, Lord, and honor your name.
We worship your name. Come on.
We worship your name.
We
worship your name.
Because you are worthy.
Because you
yes.
are worthy.
Come on, Zion.
We worship your name.
We
worship your name.
Come on.
We worship your name.
Because you are worthy.
Because you are worthy. We worship your name.
Come on, and we honor your name. Every heart say it.
one of the things I definitely want to accomplish in this record is a sense of intimacy with God, a sense of worship, a sense of the congregation singing, songs that are simple enough that the average man, the average person can come in off the street and begin to worship God, to be able to sing. One of the things with Judy, she is a wonderful writer and very spontaneous. We work so good together, and me following her and her leading me. One of the main things that I want to accomplish in this record is the sense of God, the intimacy of worship, the simplicity in songs. I want to accomplish good music, good songs, but mainly that people will worship God upon it and sing these songs. I want everyone across the country, I want this album to be so simple that people can worship in their church, that they can play it in their cars, that they can sing these songs down the line, history making.
Because you are worthy, we are.
I want raw worship, church service. I want the freedom. If the song goes 7 minutes, if it goes 8 minutes, it doesn't matter. But just church. In church, there is no, let's stop and let's do it again. I want just straight church, straight worship. And I think everyone is looking for that and definitely want that.
Love.
Well, I've seen praise and worship change, especially in the black churches, from the aspect of it become more of a participatory thing as opposed to a group watching a group. And that's what praise and worship is all about. It's a song of the people. When we start becoming a spectator in praise and worship, then we really have lost the whole purpose of praise and worship in totality, because praise and worship, again, is a song of the people to God.
That's it. Yeah. When you think about it.